गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. दिस इज अदिति वार्ष्णे वर्किंग एज सीनियर सॉफ्टवेयर कंसल्टेंट QA हेयर एट नॉल्डर्स एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू अटेंड दिस सेशन विच आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट ऑन द परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग विद JMeter. सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट टू थिंग्स हेयर, परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग एंड JMeter. वी कैन से परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग विद JMeter. सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज टू टुगेदर एंड ऑल्सो सी हाउ इवन नॉन टेक्निकल गाय कैन ईजिली डू परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग यूजिंग JMeter. सो लेट्स बिगिन बिफोर गोइंग टू द एजेंडा. लेट्स see some Nolex etiquettes. So first one is punctuality. You should always respect Nolex session timing. You are requested not to join session after a 5-minute threshold, and most important things that is feedback. Make sure submit a constructive feedback for all sessions, and it is very helpful for the presenter, and it can also help you to get better services or better session in your future session like the Nolex session. Okay, so third one is silent mode. So keep your screen on mute unless you have a query. So if you have a query in between of session on any topic, you can just unmute yourself and ask any questions. And last one is avoid disturbance. So again, this is the same, like you should keep your screen and video on mute so that presenter is audible enough. Okay, so next move ahead to our today's agenda. So this is our today's agenda. First, as I talk about performance testing, in which we will know what is performance testing and what are the type of performance testing and life cycle of performance testing. Next, I will discuss about the symptoms and issues of performance testing, what issues we faces without performance testing. And the next one is performance types of performance testing. So we'll just continue on the what are the types of performance testing. And what, why and how JMeter works, and good for performance testing or not. Okay, and last I'll just wrap up my session with installation and demo part. So let's begin with our first slide. Yeah, so performance testing. So let's understand what is performance testing. Performance testing is defined as a type of software testing to ensure software application will perform well under their expected workload, or we can say testing the stability and response time of application by applying load is called performance testing. Everyone want their product to be a good quality, so feature and functionality supported by the software system is not only the concern of quality. When software application should perform well in terms of response time, reliability, source usage, scalability, which matter a lot for the quality product. So you can just see this picture to know about the performance testing. Like see, a man is loaded with bunch of books, and how he is good under this much load, even he is not able to stand properly. So similarly, our product cannot stand in market if it is not quality product. Okay, so let's move to the next slide. So yeah, needs of performance testing. So why do we need performance testing? So first is provide performance metrics. So performance testing is done to provide stakeholders or project manager with information about their application regarding speed, or you can say response time. Okay, next one is enhance scalability and reliability of the software. Like scalability means a software can expand to support increasing workload, and reliability that how system will failure free for a specified period of time. Okay, next one is engage customer with better website speed. Like a slow and a loosey website will never draw a good audience, right? So in fact, it will repel the crowd coming on the site. So automated testing tool like any API tool or a performance testing tool, enable a team to check speed and performance of website. So in this way, with a basic connectivity and bandwidth access, user will able to load the site. So we can just give a better user experience by engaging customer with better website. So next one is resolve glitches before it goes to market. So more importantly, it uncover what need to improve before the product goes to market. So it resolve all the glitches before the product goes to market. And next one is build responsiveness of an application. So yeah, it is related to the software responding in a different condition or different user experience. So responsiveness is absolutely critical for enterprise to achieve an organization business objective. So without performance testing, software is likely to suffer issues such as running low while using several users simultaneously, inconsistency across different operating system, and like poor usability. Okay, so that's why we need to perform a performance testing. So next slide. What are the types of performance testing? So guys, am I audible right now? Okay, thank you. Yeah, so let's move to the types of performance testing. So we have different types of performance testing. So first one is load testing. Okay, so load testing is a type of performance testing, yeah, as we know, is to ensure software application will perform under their expected workload, or we can say testing the stability and response time of an application by applying load. So it's called a performance testing. So it's called a load testing. Okay, and next one is stress testing. So this involves testing an application under extreme workload, like to see it handle high traffic and data processing. Every system has a capacity limit. So when the load goes beyond the limit, the application starts responding very slow and even produces error. So the purpose of this testing is to find capacity limit of a system. So here we can verify at which point the system degrade or fails, usually done by increasing load. Next one is spike testing. So it is done by suddenly increasing or decreasing the number of load generated by the user. So by largely amount and observe the system performance. So means we just check the application can handle a dramatic change in the load, high, very high and very low. Okay, so next one is scalability testing. So it is I already just mentioned, like it is used to measure software capability to scale up or down. Like software is able to scale up or down in different workload or not. It supports what type of workload. So it is called as scalability testing. And next one is volume testing. So yeah, it is done against the efficiency in terms of like how much data the application can handle. Just like we can run that test with huge amount of data. Just like number of data is created while running the test or while executing the scripts. So that's that time we just check the system behavior, how our system is behave with huge amount of data, with huge amount of data processing. So this is during that time. So this is called volume testing. So next is endurance testing. So this type of testing is used to check the system can withstand the load for long, say 10 hours, 2 or 3 days, or large number of transaction like 200 or 500 requests. Even this testing is done with not only all the softwares, but with some software for those like we have to continuously 24 and 7 hour working of the software. So on that type of software we have to perform this type of endurance testing. So let's move on next slide. Yeah, so why to use performance testing tool? So in everyone minds, like without tool we can perform testing or not, we should use any performance tool or not. So everyone thinks what tool we should use and is it necessary to use the tool. So yeah, this will explain you why we should use the performance testing tool. So yeah, almost impossible without one. Yeah, so let's take an example. Like if we have to check how much data an application can handle, for that we need a resource to create that much data, a separate resource, and also it is very hectic job to that particular resource to do so. So getting rid of these all issues, we need to use any performance testing tool to perform this type of things, right? Like, and next one is without tool relies on massive hardware and personnel to generate load. Similarly, if we want to test our application with different users or a concurrent user, then we need number of hardware. Like one user is using one application and other user is using another application on different computer or different machine. So for checking the performance or the users concurrent user, we need different hardware and also we need to generate a load. So it's really difficult to manage and perform such tasks for the performance testing. And the cost of repeating manual tests never diminishes. Like, yeah, as ever point already described, that we need different resources to create a lot of data and massive hardware to perform load testing. And also this is not one time process. If we want to perform the performance testing in every build or in every sprint, then we will just repeat the same process in each build and each sprint. So this is really very high cost and for a small product. So it is really very costing for a small product as well. So without tool, no report are created. Yes, as we cannot create a good testing report without any tool. We can just assume the things which we just observe, but we cannot create any exact report. We need to spend much time to create a good report, but manually we cannot create exact matrices of the particular performance reports. So yeah, it is really very very hard without any tools. So what we have to capture in report, like response time. So if there is any request or if there is any page, so how can we observe the response time of particular page at each and every condition, each and every data. So it is really very difficult. Similarly, CPU utilization, disk input IO and network. So these are the various components we have to capture. These are the matrices we have to capture. We need to check with the help of tools. Without help of tools, we cannot capture these things. So let's move on next slide. Performance testing life cycle. Yeah, so how can we achieve the performance testing like if we don't have any process or plan to doing the task, then we cannot achieve that particular things. So that's why we have some performance testing life cycle. Okay, so first is identifying test environment. So yeah, just like we have to first identify the test environment, on which environment we can perform the load testing. Like if we have to perform the load testing, then we need a separate environment, because one environment is used by different people, like dev, testers, and even customers as well. So while doing load testing, we have to create a lot of data, bulk data, so server get down, and it will really affect on the work of others. So if they will be working on the same time, then it will really affect to those peoples as well. So we should identify the separate environment first, or we can just if we are not able to create another environment, so we just inform to others, like not to use the particular environment on the particular time, so we can just perform the load testing on that, and also we can just perform the load testing on in downtime as well. And next one is identifying performance acceptance criteria. So yeah, it is really important. Like, we should know about the need, requirement gathering, and SLAs of our application. Like, we should know the most critical part of our application to perform load testing, and need to know acceptance criteria and SLAs, like SLA limits, like what on which time it get crashed, or on which user it how much users it can handle, how much data it can handle. So we should know about the application acceptance criteria. So next one is plan and designs. So yeah, we have to plan the things and how we can achieve the load testing in any product with the help of any test plan. We can create any test plan and any doc, high level doc. So we can just plan the things accordingly, and we need to create scripts for to perform the testing. Like we can reuse the same each time, because every time we have to perform the same things, repeated tasks. So we can just create a script, design the test cases, design the manual test cases as well. And next one is configure and test environment. Like we need to configure the environment where we can run the design scripts and check the reports. So yeah, we have to configure that. And next one is implement test design. So in this we need to implement those planned test design which we plan during the test cases. And next one is execute test. So when test and environment are ready, then we need to execute the test as per the plan and configuration and get the reports, so that we can analyze those reports in our next part, analyze test. So this is all about the performance testing life cycle. So we first start from identifying test environment and last with analyzing reports. So we will get some detail or some matrices of performance testing, and get to know our product where it stands. So let's move to the next slide. Yeah, performance testing issues. Yeah. So we have while performance testing load testing, so we get several issues like application server, database server, web server, network server. So how will we identify what problem we are facing? So for this we get from these errors. So maybe possible reason to work on to enhance performance of any application. So these are some issues like application server. So if there is some issues in application server, so it must be it is because of a poor database running, or because of poor cache management, or because of poor session management. And if it is related to the web server, then poor server design and because of poor configuration and usage. So similarly, for database server, there should be might be a insufficient indenting, fragmented database. Or if it is related to the network server, then there may be a firewall throughput, or there is misbehaving in the load balancing and gateway route. So these are the issues we just faces in the performance testing while doing the performance testing. And these are the symptoms, just like anyone want to know what the issue is. Is it related to the performance testing or not, or is it related to other things? Like how one can know we should start a performance testing, or the particular error is related to the performance testing. So these are the symptoms of performance testing. Like if we are getting the error like this, page check error, long response time, memory leak, high CPU usage, HTTP errors, page not available, so or erroneous data return, like number of errors we are getting from the response. So we can just know, yeah, this is related to the performance testing. So we need to check our servers or something else to fix these issues. So yeah, these are the possible reasons maybe. So let's move to the next slide. Yeah, so now JMeter, so how it is related to performance testing. So I will just let you know all about JMeter, what is it, why we should use it, and how we can use it. So JMeter is one of the open source performance testing tool. So it is purely Java based desktop application. It was originally designed for a load testing of web application, but now it expanded to other test function like testing for mobile app or Android, iOS both. So we can perform all type of testing, as I explained, spike, stress, any type of testing we can perform using JMeter. So next one is, why JMeter for performance testing? So JMeter, first one is, JMeter is user friendly and extremely easy to use and does not take time to get familiar with it. So any non-technical guy can easily use the JMeter and perform the performance testing easily without knowing much about the JMeter. So also you can start your performance testing by listening this session as well. You can learn easily from this session. And next is, support various type of protocol. So it supports any protocol like HTTP, JDBC, FTP, REST, SOAP. So mostly I have used the HTTP and JDBC request in this, from these protocols. And it is platform independent. Yeah, we can use it on any operating system. And if we have created a script on Linux system or Linux OS, then we can use the same script in Windows as well. There is no issues with the OS operating system for the JMeter. And the next one is full multi-threading. So it provide multi-threading framework. Like, we want to run different set of tests simultaneously, and we can run it, and also it allow concurrent sampling by many threading. And next one is, scripting is easy. Like, if you want to write a script for data extraction or for anything, so you can just write in any language like Groovy, Java, JavaScript, VHDL, any language you can write it. And result analysis and caches, so view result analysis and the reporting part of this JMeter is really very easy. You can easily analyze the result from the JMeters. And pluggable samplers, so there is no write down. You don't need to write down anything. You just need to add the samplers, right? Just drag and drop, you can say. You don't need to write down anything. You don't need to work hard and like coding and all. So it's really easy to work on with JMeter. And record and playback, so it is very important feature of JMeter. Like, if you are non-technical and you don't have any coding knowledge about anything, like, so you can just record a particular scenario of any, like, you have to perform the performance testing on login functionality. So you can just record the login functionality scenario from recorder, and you can just customize the particular script, and you can use easily that script. So let's move. The next slide is benefits of JMeter. So as I already explained why it is so important. So first one is availability, as I already said, I think. So it is open source tool, it is free tool. You can download it from anywhere and on any operating system, and easy to maintain this. You just need to download a zip here and unzip, and you can just use that folder easily. And it is platform independent as well. And next one is load generation capacity. So you can generate any amount of load with the use of JMeter, like a load runner or a blaze meter. These are also other performance testing tools, but they are paid tools. So they are only available a limit of user or capacity or a load generator. So you have to pay a different amount to use the load capacity of concurrent users or something else. So there is no issues with it. So there is no restriction to generate a load capacity. And next one is execution. So execution is really very easy. Non-technical guy easily execute it, and you can execute it from GUI mode, non-GUI mode like CLI mode, and also you can just execute it from any CI/CD tool like Jenkins if you already integrate that tool there with JMeter and analysis report. So yeah, very good form of report JMeter. Just create like in graphs as well, in different types of report it can create. You can which you want to like or which you want to analyze. So analysis report is very easy. And open source and community support, yeah, it is open source and also it provide a community support as well. Scripting is very easy, like in other tools we have to know all about, we have to write everything. In some other tools there is no recording as well, so scripting of this tool is very easy. You can just script in any language. And building test scenarios, so it is also very easy, like you can just record and use the test scenario, or you can just replicate those test scenarios in other scripts. You don't need to learn it from any course, like certification or something else. You can just learn it by doing it yourself or recording it script. And elements, so yeah, elements of these of the JMeters are very easy to understand what it does. It already reflected by its name, so I'll just move to the next slide. Yeah, architecture of JMeter. So yeah, so it in this I will just let you know how internally the JMeter it works, but yeah, it is not important to know, but we should know how it works. So JMeter create a request to the target server, like it simulate a group of users sending requests to the target server and return statics that show the performance functionality of the target server application by graphs. So it just simulate to the server and perform their action and just give a performance report to the server, and you can just check that report easily. So this is the main architectures of JMeter. So next slide is services provided by JMeter. So basically it provided a lot of services. I just write down a little bit. So first one is distributed load testing. So as a single system cannot generate a large number of thread user, like it depend although it is there is no load capacity, but the capacity is related to our system, like just like our system is only less configuration, like 16 GB RAM or something else, so we can just perform a distributed load testing to use another PC or another system as well. Multiple system are used for the load testing. So in JMeter, a master slave configuration is used to achieve load testing. And next one is server monitoring. So collect and view server health matrices like CPU utilization and memory consumption using a plugin. It provides different plugins to get the report of CPU utilization and memory consumption. And next is recording test. So yeah, it provides easy creating of a script, like if anyone is not experienced to create the script, then he can record the script and customize it accordingly. Graph listener, it provide a very good reporting in graph as well for everything, just like CPU utilization graph. You can just check that graph, memory leak, or response time graph, running graph. So it provide a very good reports in graphs as well. And building JMeter, yeah, so it is like a open source tool, so any dev team can easily create their plugins, their features, their samplers. So you can just build the JMeter by yourself as well. And integration with CI/CD tools, so we can integrate the JMeter with any of the CI/CD tools like Jenkins or any other tool, Visual Studio as well, Maven as well. So these services provided by the JMeter are, and there are more services. We can just read it out on their documentation part. And next one is JMeter integration with CI/CD tool. So before start this, I'll just let you know why it is important to integrate the JMeter with CI/CD. So So adding performance test on your CI/CD will help you to reduce the risk of performance degradation. Whenever we add a new feature or fix a bug in our product, for example, if our latest commit inadvertently causes response time of for acceptable threshold or SLA, so our CI system will automatically raise a red flag and mark the build as failed. So this will make it very easy for we to identify the cause behind the problem. So it is really very important to integrate our JMeter with any of the CI/CD tool. So here I'll just show you the small part in demo. I already integrated my script, JMeter scripts, to Jenkins. So there is no issues with that. You just need to install the JMeter on the same machine and create a JMeter script and edit those scripts in repository, and then install Jenkins. So JMeter and Jenkins should be on the same machine. Installed on the same machine, and you just need to install a plugin in Jenkins, a JMeter plugins, and create a job. I'll just show you the job in demo part, and you can just easily run the build and analyze the result from the Jenkins as well. You don't need to go each and every time in the JMeter. Yeah, if you want to update your script, then only you have to go in JMeter. So it is very easy to integrate in your scripts with CI/CD tool. So next one is terminology. So I'll just explain each and everything in terminology, and I will also show these terminology in demo part as well. So this is test plan. So it describes series of test plan test steps JMeter will execute when run. So test plan will consist of one or more thread group, logic controller, sampler, and many more. And we will look into this. Like you can see, listeners, thread group, and config element. Next one is thread group. So these are the beginning points of any test plan thread group. All controller and sampler must be under it. Like these controller, config element, listener, and sampler are under the thread group. I'll just show you in demo. And next one is ramp up, which is most important. So there are many samplers or like controllers, timer, post processor, config element, listener. So we will use all these to create one script, or these all are used in while recording the scripts. So I'll just move to next slide. So I'll just explain each and everything in demo part as well. So yeah, it's time to demo. I'll just show you how we can record the JMeter scripts. We have two options to record. We can just use a third party tool like BlazeMeter extension to record the JMeter, and we can also use the JMeter itself to record the JMeter scripts. So I'll just move to the demo part here. Yeah, so I'll just first show you recording with BlazeMeter. Okay, so there is an extension called this BlazeMeter Chrome extension. So you just need to add this extension in your Chrome browser and log in with your Google accounts or anything, so that you can able to save the particular script. Okay, so I want to record the Nolder's website. Okay, so I want to record the service part, or I want to just record the UI part of this website. So what I have to do with this BlazeMeter extension, I just click on that and just name it, name anything like testing one or testing something. Okay, so you just need to click on start recording. There is no technical task for to do. So just reload the particular URL and waiting. Yeah, so it is just recording the requested it get from this UI, and just click manually what you want to test, like so you know, like on service page there is a more hit left, so you just click on this. And yeah, if there is something to create, like data to create, so it can easily record the post as well, post request as well. Okay, so I'll just create on inside, click on inside industries accelerators. So I think so many requests get recorded, so I'll just stop the test. So yeah, there is an option, you can just explore all these options, like run. You can, if you will click on run, so it will just run the recorded script inside the Blaze meter, not in JMeter. So we don't want to use the Blaze meter here, because Blaze meter is paid tool and there is restrictions to use in free version. Okay, so you can just save it directly, or you can just click on edit. Yeah, so you can just remove or move the requested which you don't want to save. Okay, so for now I'm just not deleting anything. And yeah, so there are three options. You can just download the this recording. This is YAML, and this is in JSON, and this is in .jmx. So JMeter support .jmx file. So we will just record save the particular recording in .jmx file. So yeah, it just asks for the domain which you want to select. Just like there are so many domains opened in the tab, so you can just select the domain which you want to save. So I'll just select noldas.com with the URL which I recorded. So it will just automatically save in your download folder. Okay, so yeah, I'll just show you how we can run the JMeter on Linux. So yeah, so I already downloaded the Apache JMeter 5.3 version. So as per the version, latest version, you can download it from the website. Okay, so you have to just, this is in zip folder, so you have to just unzip the particular folder and just go to the Apache JMeter 5.3 and go to the bin. Okay, so yeah, so it is a similar folder for every OS. On Windows and on Linux, it will download the same. So if your system is Windows, then you will just need to run the bat jmeter.bat file to open the GUI of JMeter. And if you are using Linux system, then you will use jmeter.sh file to run the same to go to the UI. Okay, so I already opened one window of it. So I'll just open it another from the terminal. sh jmeter.sh command. You have to just type this and enter. You are able to go get the window of JMeter GUI. Yeah, so it is loading. Yeah, so this is the JMeter GUI. Okay, so now I'll just import the particular script which I recorded from the Blaze Meter extension. So I'll just open that particular. So I'll just name it testing1.jmx. Yeah, so it can automatically record all the things it have, like these are the headers, config elements it already recorded, and this is the thread group, this is the controllers, and under it we have the request, HTTP request. Okay, so one by one I'll just go through each and everything. So yeah, it is HTTP header, so header manager, so it automatically record the value of this. Okay, And next one is user defined variable, like if something is used repeatedly in the recording, like URL is used in every request, so it all automatically create a variable called base URL1 and save and use the value this noldus.com. So it will you on all over the request, this URL is used for the URL path. I'll just show you that. And next one is HTTP request default. So it if we have a repeated request or something else we will use, so we can just use it before the these requests. So this is the test plan, and under the test plan we have a config element. And next one is a thread group. Under the thread group we have transaction controllers, and under the controllers we have a request. Okay, so this is the hierarchy of a JMeter script. Okay, and you can just delete or put as per your need what you need in the headers. Okay, so next is thread group. Yeah, so thread group I already explained why it is used. So we can just add a number of thread here, concurrent user, like it is by default it just recorded as one, because recorded it one time. Okay, so not one time, I recorded this script, so that's why user is one. Okay, so you can just increase or decrease the user as per your configuration or as per your SLA limits. Okay, so these are the virtual user. Okay, and ramp up is the time taken by the JMeter to complete all threads, like all users or list. And take an example, like I'll just show you explain what is the meaning of ramp up time. So we have a 10 thread here, okay, like this in the thread group, and we set the 10 second in the ramp up. Okay, so JMeter will take 10 second to get all 10 thread up and running. And also when we will divide the ramp up with thread group 10 by 10, so each thread will be up in every 10 second, just like first user will up in first second, and another user is will be up in another second, two user will be up in next 2 second, and similarly last 10 second all the 10 users are running there. Okay, and loop count is how many times you want to run the scripts. So I'll just add the one, and if you will just infinite, so it will run infinite times. You can just add the delay of thread creation, and you can just specify the time. Yes, I already explained endurance testing, for you have to run the test for long duration. So you can just add the duration, like 2-3 days as per the seconds. Okay, so next is controller, and these are the requests. Okay, so you can just check this is the base URL and this is the path. You can say it API, and it is a get call. So if there is a post call, then we will have a body data or a parameter. So we will just need to customize these thing only. Like if we have a post API, then the hard coded data will be shown there, like username or password. So you can just variableize it there, or you can just pass it from any CSV data config. It has a CSV data config as well, like this. Yeah, so you can just use this to use the external data or use in Excel file. Okay, so these are the requests. So after recording you just need to add the listener first. If you want to run default configuration, you can just need to add the listener only. So I'll just show you how we can add the listeners. So yeah, these are the listeners. In this we will just get the report or the results here. So yeah, I'll just add two listener, view result tree and aggregate aggregate report. I'll just let you know why I just add these two only. We can add number of listeners as per the need. Okay, like graph results, save response to a file, view result in table, bean shell. So each and every has its own role as per the needs you want. Okay, so but these two are good to start your testing, just like for a beginner. Oh. So view result tree is in this you can just check the response and request of particular request when you will run this script, and in aggregate report you will get these matrices like average response time, median response time, 90 percentile, error percentage, throughput and samplers. Okay, so that's why I'll just add two things like if I need these matrices, then I can just save the particular data after running, or also we can just add the file name here. And if we want to check why the request get failed, then we can just check the in view result tree response and request time. So on non-GUI mode we can use these two listeners, on GUI mode we can use these two listeners to check the response, and on GUI mode we don't need to use this view result tree. Okay, and next one more thing in this, you can just check the logs if you are getting any error related. So it JMeter provides a logging system as well here. And next part is recording with HTTP proxy.
Can we export those reports as well?
You can export those reports as well easily. You can just save. I'll just show you where it is. Okay, I'll just add. Yeah, you can just export those reports. You can provide your file name so that after running the script or execution, the report gets saved automatically in a particular file name. Or you can just click on save button from another file. You can just save the particular report. I'll just show you the button I have.
Hi Aditi. Yeah. So time is like up, so please wrap up quickly.
Yeah, I have. Okay. Yeah, so it is aggregate report, so you can just click on save table data, so it just save the data in Excel format easily, each and everything it is showing. Okay, so next is recording with HTTP proxy, like recording with JMeter only, how we can record the script in with JMeter. So you can just need to add the proxy in Mozilla Firefox. So or you can add the proxy in any browser. Okay, so I just use the Mozilla Firefox because it is not used much by me. So I'll just show you how we can record using HTTP proxy. So you just need to set the proxy setting here. Okay, so JMeter support port 8888 and localhost. You just need to set the manual proxy configuration. Okay, and you just need to add this script recorder. I'll show you how we can just use add this. So just go to this template part and add this and create. So give the URL which you want to record here, like noldus.com and whatever you want to. Okay, and just click on start. I'll just give the same. Yeah, like this. Okay, and you can just name it accordingly. Okay, so it is you have to just enable it and just start. It automatically take a port this. Okay, so yeah, this is a certification of Apache JMeter. So you have to just use that certification in your browser as well. So you have to just import that certification is like this. I already imported it. This, so it you can just get in bin folder of JMeter. Okay, so you can just name your transaction at the time of recording, and when you just when you just click on this, the recording will get started, and you can just record each and everything here which you want like earlier. Okay, so I'll just stop the recording here, and you will get the things in this. Yeah, all the requests get recorded. And also the result, you will get the result from this. The benefit of using HTTP proxy setting or HTTP test script recorder is this. You can just get to know the response and request from this recording. But from the BlazeMeter, it only record the APIs or a main request, not each and every request it recorded. While the HTTP test script recorder, it record everything, every request. So you need to work on it. You need to delete the request here. So that's why I personally prefer to use BlazeMeter extension to record the script. And also you can learn easily from that script, BlazeMeter script. Like, because it is very in good manner, that's why. So this is all about the demo part, and for the JMeter integration, I have to show. Actually, it is in my different PC, so I have to show. I have to share the screen from my different browser. Can I show you? We have a time to share that.
Thank you, Diti.
So these are the references. You can just go through the Apache documentation and use the BlazeMeter as well. So any questions?
No, Diti, I think we are good.
Thank you for listening.
Thanks, Diti.